Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. In today's video, I'm going to be giving you some of my best tips on how to study for your finals. Because I know a lot of us have been having online finals right now due to Corona and things like that, and I know it can be really difficult, especially when you're already struggling in your classes to begin with, because moving to online has been a really big transition. So I just actually finished a bunch of my online finals, so I hope that these tips can help you. I know that they definitely helped me to still get good grades on my finals despite them being online. So I'm gonna give you tips for how I actually learn the information and also ways that you can stay motivated, because I know it's really hard to stay motivated right now, especially when it comes to studying for classes that you're already struggling with. I can definitely relate to that. So I really hope that these tips can help you. But before we get into the video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel down below if you're not already subscribed, and give this video a thumbs up. And without further ado, let's just get right on into the video. Okay, so this tip should help you, especially if you are studying for like math or science finals. I found it especially helps me with, but study with your friends. I know that you're probably thinking, well, I can't go out and see my friends, and obviously maintain social distancing, but you can FaceTime your friends or do a big group Zoom call with all of your friends. I know I did that a couple times, but one of my biggest tips for studying with friends is to teach each other the content and the information. So everyone can kind of make a list of the things that they don't necessarily understand that well, and then there's this app, or not this app, it's this website, it's completely free, it's kind of attached to like Google and things like that, and it's called Jamboard, and it's really great. I've used this a couple times while I have been studying. So basically, if one of your friends said that it didn't understand a certain concept, and one of your other friends is like, I did understand that concept, everyone can get on a big group call, and then everyone can join the Jamboard, and whoever it is that understands, or if there's multiple people, they can write on the board and everybody else can see what they're writing. So not only does that help everybody understand concepts they don't necessarily understand, it also helps the person who is explaining it, because then they remember it a lot better. Some of my friends from my chemistry final, I was explaining certain things to them and I was using that, and it really helps because you're not just explaining it, you're actually writing it out. So I find that it helps everybody remember so much better, and then plus you can save the Jamboards and everyone can refer back to them later. So that's a really great tip, and it's really helped me. My next tip is to create a study schedule before you even begin studying. I know I've talked about this in a few of my videos, but I am just going to do a quick little overview of it now. So basically what I mean by a study schedule is you make kind of a timetable of all the days that you need to study before you even begin studying. So let's say you have 14 days until your exam. You're going to line out exactly what you're going to do on all 14 of those days. So let's say day one, you're going to review chapter one, you're going to review all of your assignments for chapter one, you're going to do such and such practice questions. You're kind of creating a blueprint for yourself so that you know exactly what to study every day. This is helpful for a couple of reasons. One, because then that way it's not going to be the day before the final exam and you're realizing that you forgot to study an entire section or chapter or something like that, because you have it all lined out from the beginning. And it also helps you stay motivated, because for me personally, I would never want to get behind or not study that day, because then I knew that I'd have double the work to do the next day, because I have to check off all the little check boxes. That's just how my brain works. So then I would never want to get behind, because I knew I'd have to do double the next day, and I knew that I definitely didn't want to do that. So it helps with motivation as well as making sure that you stay on track with your studying. The next thing that you should do right before you even begin studying at all is to make a Quizlet of all of your vocabulary words. Quizlet is just personally what I use to make flashcards. I find that it really helps me the best. Or you can write out flashcards, or I'm sure there's other flashcard apps as well that you can look into, but I personally use Quizlet because there's lots of things that you can do. You can play little games, like memorize games, you can do flashcards, you can do writing the words and definitions out, things like that. So I just find there's lots of different ways that you can use the app, and it's completely free. You can like upgrade, but I never have. I just use the free version and it works great. And then you have all your vocabulary words from the start, and because memorizing vocabulary words is not something you want to do the day before the final, I recommend studying your vocabulary words for 30 minutes every single night after you're done studying, and then that way by the time it is your final, they will all be in your head already, as opposed to just doing it a couple days before the final. If you do it just consistently every single day from the beginning of your studying to the end, then it'll ensure that you actually have them all memorized. What I actually did this year that I found really helped me is, because I was super unmotivated to study, because normally what I'll do is I'll just write out my notes on like a Word document or something like that, everything that I need to have memorized, but what I decided to do was make a pretty PowerPoint instead. So I didn't want to make sure like a boring old Word document, so I went to the site SlidesGo to find really pretty templates. The site Slides Carnival also has a bunch of pretty templates if you want some other ones as well, but I just downloaded a template and used it as a Google Slides presentation, and then I've been putting all my information on there, and then that way it's all organized, and stuff that's visually appealing is a lot easier for me to memorize. I don't know about you guys. But basically, I just write down all my notes on there. So for stuff that's not like vocabulary or anything like that, but just things that you need to know, I recommend putting it all down there. And then when it's a couple days before your final, you can just go through the entire PowerPoint and make sure that you have everything memorized. That's what I did. And a little added motivation is if you make it pretty, because I know that that really motivated me a lot. Okay, this is a tip for if you're struggling to actually get motivated and start studying and keeping your focus as well. So I set a timer on my phone for 30 minutes and I make it so that I have to study for those entire 30 minutes. So I like chuck my phone across the room, whatever I need to do, I'll put it on my bed and go study at my desk, or even I'll go as far to put it in another room. Actually, well, if you want to hear the timer, I guess you could set the timer on like a clock or on your computer or something else, but I just put my phone as far away from me as possible. And then when the timer goes off, you can kind of set a time for how long you want your break to be. So if you want to study for 30 minutes and have a 5-minute break, or 45 and have a 10-minute break, figure out what works for you and how long you can maintain your focus for. I personally do 30 minutes and then I take a 5-minute break to go on my phone. And I find that just really helps me because I'm a lot more motivated to go study, because I'm like, okay, all I have to do is study for 30 minutes and then I'll get a break. And if you break it up into chunks like that, it makes it a lot more manageable. Another thing that you can do if you are struggling to begin your studying for the day, or you're just finding that you're not wanting to do it, is when you make your little study blueprint, actually put a time besides all of the activities. So you can be like, okay, so I need to review vocabulary, I'm gonna do that at 3 p.m. I need to review some assignments, I'm gonna do that at 4 p.m., things like that. If you assign a time to every single task, then you're gonna be much more likely to complete it. Because I know for me, if I try to tell myself like, yeah, I'm just gonna study sometime later today, I don't know what time yet though, it'll be like 11 p.m. and I'll be like, crap, I need to study. And then you're studying till like 3 o'clock in the morning. So I found that by setting a time, then you're gonna be way less likely to put it off. And I recommend that you set your time somewhere in the middle of the day, unless you're a super early early bird, you might not want to start studying first thing in the morning, and also studying way too late, like I did sometimes, makes you just really tired and you're not gonna necessarily retain the information better. But I recommend studying sometime after lunch, and then I find that's kind of like the perfect time to get some of your work done. Sometimes reviewing your notes is just not enough. You have to take it that extra step and do some practice problems as well. So I know sometimes teachers actually give out practice problems and things like that that you can do before the exam. But if your teacher did not give you any practice problems, then usually there's quite a few practice tests and practice problems with solutions in the textbook, even if the solutions aren't necessarily super detailed. But usually there is practice problems in the textbooks with answers. And if there is not, or if you don't have a textbook, usually if you Google that concept online and then put the word practice after, usually you'll be able to find certain worksheets and stuff, because I know a lot of teachers like to go online to find free resources that they can actually give their kids in class. So a lot of times teachers do put their resources and practice things up there with an answer key provided. So if you Google a specific topic and then put practice beside it, I found that that has helped me to find a lot of really good free resources for practice problems. So give that a try. And the last thing that I recommend doing if you want to do well on your finals is review all of your old assignments, quizzes, tests, etc. Review everything that you can, because I know a lot of times teachers, when they're making the final exam, they will put questions that are almost the exact same on their final exam as they did on the assignment. And sometimes they'll literally put the exact question on. I know there's a couple times with my finals this semester where I was like, I just saw this question yesterday when I was reviewing my notes. So oftentimes they will do that, or sometimes they will just change the numbers or the wording of the question, but it'll be like the exact same concept. So I recommend going over all your old assignments and tests, and oftentimes your assignments and tests will be harder than the final exam, especially your assignments, because you do have access to your notes for your assignments. So oftentimes they'll be harder. So if you can make sure that you can do all the questions from the assignments, you'll probably be okay for the final exam. At least that's been my experience. And if there's a concept from your notes that you are specifically struggling with, then I recommend that you actually do those questions again that pertain to that subject in your assignments, and actually do those questions again to see if you can get them right. Okay, so those were all my tips. I really hope that these were helpful for you guys and that this can help you guys do well in your finals. I wish you all the best of luck. Even if they are online, you can do this. I believe in you. And yeah, I hope that you guys all have a great rest of your day and that you crush your finals, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye!